on the right side of the cartridge, remove the screws. They are three. The position is indicated by the red arrows. Remove the side cover plate. The reset gears are attached to the cover plate. The gears reset the machine page counter when a new toner cartridge is installed. Remove the black plastic spacer. Remove all the gears. Make sure that the gears are clean. Leaving dirty toner in the teeth of one of the gears may damage the tooth and cause a clicking noise or other problems. Press it on the locking tab of the developer roller. Rotate the developer roller lockup. Slide the developer roller and remove it. Using a screwdriver, remove the fill plug from the toner cartridge. Dump the remaining toner and clean the cartridge. Do not breathe the toner dust. It's better to use compressed air. The toner remaining in the cartridge when the cartridge is finished is waste toner. It's not reusable and must be completely removed from the cartridge before adding a new toner. Failure to do this may cause bad grounding and low quality prints. In Brother technology, the waste toner is ripped out of the drum and put back into the cartridge. This is why there will always be a good quantity of toner left in the finished cartridge. It's not necessary to remove the doctor blade. The doctor blade can be easily cleaned by wiping down with a cloth and isopropyl alcohol. The doctor blade regulates the amount of toner over the developer roller. If the developer roller felts are compressed, gently rough them up with a screwdriver. Clean the developer roller with isopropyl alcohol. Reinstall the developer roller. Turn the lock towards the doctor blade until it locks in place. Fill the cartridge with 100 grams of toner for use in Brother. Universal Brother toner will works fine. Replace the fill plug and check for leaks. Reinstall all the gears and the developer roller black axle spacer. Make sure all the gears are meshing properly. To reset the counter, pull out the two little gears. Compatible cartridges made in China may have different set of reset gears. Now, put back the flat gear. This is the right position. Reinstall the two little gears. Install the gear cover plate. Reinstall the three screws. And the work is done.